Hello everybody, this is Drew, aka Walmart Killer. I am back again. This time I'm going to be bringing you a new little mini-series. I don't know how many y'all play, but I'm going to play a few episodes here and there. And this is called The Stanley Parable. Everybody's heard of this game by now, but I have not played it myself. I haven't touched it at all. I overlooked this at first, this little window and window and window. And it follows you through every screen. I mean, look at this. Every screen. And it's doing it on all of them. You can see it. It's going through all the little selectables there. That's pretty awesome. So we're just going to dive right in. D is never the end. Is never the end. Is never the end. Is never the end. Wow. Okay. Got that inceptional end or whatever the crack. I'm not sure. You gonna load more? Okay. I got this turned up to the absolute highest max settings because, come on, it's just a simple little game. Or is it? Hell, is it even a game? Sometimes I wonder, and I haven't even played this thing yet. I've just seen video of it. I'm not going to skip.
This is the story of a man named Stanley. Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427.
Okay.
Employee number 427's job was simple. He sat at his desk in room 427 and he pushed buttons on the keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. Although others might have considered it soul-rending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in, as though he had been made exactly for this job. And Stanley was happy. And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour, when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow.
Old school computer, man.
No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi. Never in all his years at the company had this happened, this complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time. But as he came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
No. Okay. This is just an ordinary looking room. And look at the detail they went into. I can't crouch. Oh, I can crouch. It's just control, okay. Okay, I'm out. Now what, dude? Mr. Narrator. Can I close that door? Oh, I can close the door. Can I go back in? I can't go back in. Well, let me open up that door. No.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean? Stanley decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo. No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Oh, yeah? Well, how do I know you're not tricking me? Can I close that door? Well, let me close that door. Okay. Okay, well, screw you then. Can I close that door? I can close that door. And I can open that door back up. Alright, that's something. We're getting somewhere. All the doors are numbered. How am I supposed to know where the meeting room is? Does that say? I hate Mondays. Here you there, brother. Oh, that's a really good macro photo. Okay, so can I get in there? What? That's just so weird. Why would they? Well, whatever. 420, man. Got that pot.
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference. Nor did it advance the story in any way.
Hey, you shut up. I'll advance the story when I damn well want to, fucker.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
What? So you trying to tell me that you have full control and you're going to tell me where to go? Mm-mm. I'm noticing a little bit of... I think that's some screen tearing. Give me just a sec. I'm going to pause and come back. All right, well, I can't mess with it right now, but it looks like I'm going to have to turn on vertical sync outside of the game. You told me to go to the left? Well, fuck you. I'm going to the right. How about
this
that?
This was not the correct way to the meeting room.
I don't care.
Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's it. I wanted to go in there and look up some porn on your computer. Can I do anything? No? Alright.
Ah, yes. Truly a room worth admiring. It had really been worth the detour after all, just to spend a few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room.
Immaculate?
Stanley simply stood here, drinking it all in.
What's that say? Who farted?
Really, really worth it being here in the room.
Number one, Dad.
Room so utterly captivating that even though all your co-workers have mysteriously vanished, here you sit looking at these chairs and some paintings. Really
Fuel.
Worth it.
Dude, seriously, you are an asshole. Coffee nut.
At this point, Stanley's obsession with this room bordered on creepy and reflected poorly on his overall personality. It's possible that this is why everyone left.
Really? They all left because of me?
At last, he'd had enough of the amazing room and took the first open door on his left to get back to business.
First open door on my left, huh? Yeah, screw you. Alright, so let's get a look at this room that I'm in now.
Stanley was so bad at following directions,
oh,
it's
shit.
Incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
Yeah. Screw you! Screw you! Okay, plans. Nice. These guys are still working on shit. Okay, that door doesn't close behind us. Huh. Okay. Pretty ordinary looking. Do not jump from the cargo lift when it's in motion. Will cause death. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift. $1,000. Penalty for jumping off the cargo lift, $5,000. Wow. So you'll die, and they'll fine you $5,000.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here. I'm not your enemy, really, I'm not. I realize that investing your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you all this time. There's someone you've been neglecting, Stanley. Someone you've forgotten about.
What?
Please, stop trying to make every decision by yourself. Now, I'm not asking for me, I'm asking for her.
Her?
This is it, Stanley. Your chance to redeem yourself.
Wow, look
to
at that.
To put your work aside, to let her back into your life. She's been waiting.
Who is this she? What? You're not going to tell me any kind of story, and you're just going to go, oh, this door is going to close behind me. Watch. What the fuck?
That's her, Stanley. You need to be the one to do this. To reach out to her. If you can truly place your faith in another, then pick up the phone.
Okay, I'll pick up the phone. When I want to, can I unplug this bitch?
As Stanley picked up the phone, a white light engulfed him.
Ha,
filling
I unplugged
him not
it.
Just with radiance, but with hope. Hope for a life reunited one... Wait. Oh, goodness. Stanley, did you just unplug the phone?
Haha,
no,
hell yeah, I did.
It was supposed to be a choice. How did you do that? You actually chose incorrectly. I didn't even know that was possible. Let me double check.
You weren't flipping
no,
through pages. You're a robot.
Here, clear as day. Stanley picks up the phone. He's taken to his apartment where he finds his wife, and the two pledge themselves to one another. Music comes in, fade to white, roll credits. Not picking up the phone is actually somehow an incorrect course of action. How is that even possible? None of these decisions were supposed
how
to
how is it
anything.
Still blinking?
I don't understand.
It's not plugged up to
how
power.
How are you making meaningful choices? What did you... Wait a second. Did I just see... No, that's not possible. I can't believe it. How had I not noticed it sooner?
What?
You're not Stanley. You're a real person.
I can't believe I was so mistaken. This is why you've been able to make correct and incorrect choices. And
you're a real person?
You run around in this game for so long. If you've made any more wrong choices, you might have negated it entirely. It's as though you completely ignored even the most basic safety protocol for real-world decision-making. Or did you not grasp the severity of the situation? Well, I won't have that kind of risk on my watch. I'm going to stop the game for a moment so we can educate you properly on safe decision-making in the real world.
Wait, what? Let me stop the
Please
game.
Observe this helpful instructional video.
Oh, screw you. Wait, what?
Choice. It's the best part of being a real person. But if used incorrectly, it can also be the most dangerous. For example, in this scenario, a hypothetical real person named Steven has a choice. He could spend years helping improve the quality of life for citizens of impoverished third world nations.
Wow, he's helping them smoke.
Or he could systematically set fire to every orphan living in a 30-kilometer radius of his house. Which choice would
the
you
kid's
make?
The kid's still like, yeah.
Remember that unlike here, the real world makes sense, and at no time should you make a choice that does not conform to rational logic. If you find yourself speaking with a person who does not make sense, in all likelihood, that person is not real. Allow the person to finish their thought, then provide an excuse why you cannot continue talking. Turn to a partner and practice saying, "My goodness, is it 4:30? I'm supposed to be having a back sack and crack."
What the hell does that mean? What? Is this B-Sod? Practice?
Excellent. Making choices on a regular basis is the best part to a healthy decision-making process.
That's nuts.
Most medical professionals recommend making at least 8 choices per day. Do you make more than 8? Less? And finally, if you begin to wonder if your choices are actually meaningful and whether you'll ever make a significant contribution to the world, just remember that in the vast infiniteness of space, your thoughts and problems are materially insignificant.
Probably smaller than that.
And the feeling should subside. At this time, your instructor will guide you in an exercise to test and reinforce the material covered in this video.
Right.
Ah, well,
whoa,
back.
What the fuck?
I have noticed that this room has begun to deteriorate as a result of narrative contradiction. But not to worry. Now that you're
what
properly
the
informed
fuck?
On good decision-making, we're going to revisit a choice you made
Danger
just a few
everywhere?
Minutes ago and see what the correct thing to do would have been. This way, please.
No, screw you. I'll stay in here, thank you very much. Nope. What, nothing's gonna happen? He's not gonna do something? Alright, fine. Okay. Nope, there it goes. Can I go back in there now? No, it won't let me. Okay, so he wants me to go back the other way I came, huh? What an asshole. Let me jump off, come
now
on.
Now that we know your choices are meaningful, we can't have you jumping off the platform and dying.
Imagine
the main character dying senselessly halfway through the story. That
this isn't halfway.
No sense at all. We just need to get you home as soon as possible before the narrative contradiction gets any worse. Unfortunately, it seems this place is not well equipped to deal with reality.
What? Well equipped to deal with reality? Come on, let me jump off that thing.
Damn you and your fence.
Ugh. Okay. Okay, I guess we're going out this way. See if I can notice any changes. What the shit? I don't want to go forward. No. 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 Damn it. Trying to take the photo down or the painting. No. Trying to use that. Nope. Didn't it have like a ladder in it before? Probably the wrong room.
Almost there. You'll take the door on the left, back to the correct ending, the story will have resolution once again, and you'll be home free in the real world.
How about you eat a dick? Tell me what to do and all this shit. I'll take whatever damn door I want.
All you need to do is behave exactly as Stanley would. That means choosing responsibly and always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine. All right. When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Yep, fuck you.
No! Why did you do that?
Wow, quickly, what the
hurry
hell?
Back in the other direction. Perhaps we're not too late.
Look at that shit. I'm fucking up reality by doing the opposite thing. That's great. Yep, not gonna do it, buddy. Going back. Haha. Look at that. Huh. Oh, wow. The painting. They, like, joined together or some shit. Alright, let's not go there through the door he wants me to go through. No, well, let me do that. I guess I have to go this way. Does it close? It doesn't close. Alright. What the hell? Why is it all white?
Oh, it's ruined.
Yeah.
I can't believe, after everything we talked about, that you... My story! You've destroyed my work! Why? For what? What did you get out of that? What did you think was so special about seeing the game undone, left here like so much garbage? It's worthless now. And what am I supposed to do?
Termination Tuesdays?
To continue, would it be worth it? To know that my story is now incorrect? How can I go back to that? I can't erase that knowledge. I'll have to live with it forever. Reliving its impossibility forever. I couldn't live that way. Is it better to shut the game down entirely? To willingly destroy all of my work? I don't know. What's the answer? What do I do? What do I do? What do I... No, I have to. I have to shut the game down. I have to. I have to.
What the hell? What? Man, you can't just shut the game down. Come on.
Thought you were so clever. Now look where we are. My entire game is destroyed. It was the only thing in the world that was mine, and you've run it into the ground.
Good.
What, did you think that would be funny?
Yeah.
You just had to see? Didn't I impress upon you how important it was to be like Stanley? He actually knows how to do what I tell him to. He understands that if I say to do something, there's a damn good reason for it. That thought hadn't even occurred to you, had it? That there's a world outside of you? You're a child. Oh. My story.
Wow. Throwing stones in a glass house, yo.
If you just gone through the door on the left, you would have seen it. There was a whole underground facility. You would have destroyed it and been victorious. It would have been so perfect.
That really sounds like Half-Life, buddy.
I tried so hard.
What the?
Is behave exactly as Stanley would.
What the shit?
Choosing responsibly.
What the shit?
Always putting the story first. I'm quite sure you'll be up to the task. Just follow my lead and you'll be fine.
What the shit?
When
was that a glitch?
Came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
Right. Well, anyway, this is Walmart Killer, and I'm gonna end it for now, and I will see you cool cats later. Man, I'm gonna have to do a part 2 on this. This is getting good. So, anyways, later, man.